Welcome to the Django project, DJ Blogger. This tutorial is part of a YouTube Django project playlist, which you can access in the video description. You can watch the whole course from the very beginning. If you enjoy this course and would like all the updated tutorials and associated code samples and more, you can check out this course and other courses this project features at Udemy. The link to the course is in the video description. Typically, when building any application with any programming language, we try to follow the DRY principle, don't repeat yourself. And that feeds over to the Django templating system, which provides us the tools for us to build templates, if you will. And we can then import other templates, other HTML pages into other HTML pages, thus being able to reuse code. So here we're going to build a base template. That template is going to be included in every single page that we create. And what that means is that we don't then need to repeat some of the basic markup that we're going to need to include in every single HTML page that we build. If you watched the previous tutorial, we did already create our template folder and we already tested out and ensured that this folder works correctly with our view. So now we're going to go into our templates folder and let's create a new file, not in the blog folder, in the templates folder, the outer folder here. Let's go ahead and create a new file. We're going to call this base.html. So this is going to have the basic markup, the HTML that's going to be needed for every single template or every single web page that we build here in our templates. What we can do, we can organize your templates however you like. In actual fact, let's go ahead and just build a new folder here. Let's just call this the base folder. And inside of here, we're going to find the base template and other base templates that we might utilize in other templates within our application. So we're going to put this base template in our base folder. We have an index page here in our blog. So now we're ready to start to build our page. So let me just give you a quick overview of HTML. So every single HTML page starts with HTML tag and ends with a HTML tag. Okay, so every page will start with HTML and end HTML. These are HTML tags. Right, so HTML is a tagging language. So every page, every template that we build that's going to be presented on the browser, on the user side, is going to have a head section. So this head section is essentially just metadata. So inside of here, you're going to have metadata such as like the title of the page and information regarding the page. So that's your metadata. And then anything that's going to be displayed in the actual browser for people to see, that all needs to go inside of the body tags here. So everything we write that's going to be displayed and rendered onto the page to the user is going to be inside the body tags. So that really is the basics of HTML. Now, the thing is here that this needs to be on every single template that is going to be rendered by the browser. So every time we send a HTML page back to the user's browser, this needs to be on it. So what we're going to do is we're going to build this base, which is going to have this base code here. And then every time we need it, we're going to call it within our template, thus not having to then rewrite this code every single time. So essentially, we're just reusing this base every time we build a new template. So the plan is here to utilize Bootstrap, which is a framework which is going to provide us the tools to quickly build our application. So let's go over to Bootstrap. So you can see it's a HTML, CSS, JavaScript library, which is going to provide tools to help us quickly build our front end. Now, if we go into docs and then you go over to the quick start here, you can see it gives us this overview or this template here that we can utilize to actually build our page. And you can see it includes the HTML tags, the body tags, and the head tag. You can see there's some additional information here. So let's go ahead and utilize this. So this is the basic one here, number two. So we've got some CSS and JavaScript. So essentially what's happening here, like Django, there's a lot of things already pre-created. So essentially we're just hooking into that pre-created code so that we can quickly build our application. So it does already have a CSS page here, a CSS document, sorry, which has lots of code in it, which will help us style some things that we include on our page. So let's go ahead and grab this one here. I think so. Yeah, let's grab this second one here, which includes everything that we're going to need. So I'm just going to copy that or click here, copy that. Let's go back to our code, into our base. Let's put that into our base here. And you can see it's quite large, so I can just wrap that. If you go to view, you can word wrap this if you like to make it viewable. So you can see the sections in place. We've got the head section here, the body section here, and then we have the HTML outer HTML tags. So this doc type here just tells the browser that the code here that we're using is HTML5. That's what this doc tag really is for here. And you can see that there are some metadata here regarding scale and views. So that the page view is viewed correctly on the in the browser. We have a title, and then we have a link here to CSS, the Bootstrap CSS, which is going to have all the code, which is going to help us quickly build and style our application, our templates. In addition to that, you can see down here we have some script, some JavaScript, looks like, which is, again, code that's pre-written that's going to help us perform and create our application. So with that in place, let's just try this out. Now, obviously this, I say obviously, this doesn't work at the moment because remember, we are only serving the index page of our blog. So if we run the server, let's just get this started. Let's go back to our browser here, open up a new tab. So you can see we still have Hello World, which is coming from the index page. So let's now learn how to actually utilize this base within our template. So we're going to inherit or we're going to include this code in our index page here so we can start to reuse the base on all of our templates. So Django provides us a range of different templating tools. So what we can do first then, let's go ahead and we're going to extend. So we're going to extend this page. So this index page here, we're going to extend and include another page, another HTML page. So we just need to define that. Now this is where an understanding of how to move in and out, up and down the folders here comes in really handy. Now remember that dot dot dash means that we go back a folder. So let's imagine we're in this blog folder. If we want to go back one into the templates folder, remember the blog folder is in the templates folder, then we need to use dot dot dash. So that takes me back one. I can chain it together. So if I want to move into the DJ blogger folder here, I use dot dot dash to get out the blog folder into the templates folder and then dot dot dash again. And that takes me out and goes into the DJ blogger folder. So that allows me to kind of move around the folders here. So I need to find my base. So I need to go out of the blog folder into the templates. And then I need to go into the base folder. And then inside of there, we have the base.html. So that's where I'm going to find the base HTML page. So let's take a look, see what that looks like now. You can see here that it says invalid block tag on line one, extend. Did you forget to register or load this tag? So the reason why that is because it's extends, not extend, apologies. Let's try that again. Refresh. And this time you can see that Hello World is very much bigger and looks like it's in bold because this time in actual fact, we no longer have any code here on this index page because we're using all the code that's from this base here. So essentially we've just inherited or we've included all this code now in the index page here. And that's how we're going to now extend all of our pages. So we are going to need some control here because when we extend this base.html page here, what we want to do, what we want to end up doing on our index page is adding code right here. That's what we need to do. So we need a way of telling Django, in actual fact, we want to use this template, but we only want to type code here in our index page. That's our goal because we have all the other code, the outer code. So we just need to write some inner code here in this index page. So how to do that? We need to add some blocks. So let's define some blocks. So what we're going to do here is essentially define a block. And then we're going to override that block in other templates. So here we're going to say, for example, block template. Okay. You can call it whatever you like, template, index, whatever. And then we need to end this block. So when we start a block, typically we need to end a block to tell Django that's where it ends. So end block. So this is a block. We can add some initial code inside of here, or else we can leave it blank. But essentially what we're going to do now on the index page, we're going to reference that block right here. So let's just reference this block here. And we're going to add some code. So code here. So what's going to happen now is that we're going to utilize this base template here. And then what we're going to do on the base template, we're going to override that block with this code here. So this block here is going to be overridden. Thus, the code will then appear inside of the body and then appear on our page. Okay, so we're just overriding that block. So let's take a look at that, see if that works. And there we go, it says code here. So we can use this principle now to change a range of different aspects of our page. If we go back to the base page here, let me just get rid of these other pages. If we go back to the base page, we see that we have a title. So this title represents what is shown here, you see in this tab here, and it might be different on different browsers. So that's what this title is referring to here. This is what's shown in the tab here. So what we can do, or what we want to do, is we want to potentially change this per page. So again, like we saw earlier, what we can do is we can just add a block here. So let's do exactly that. So let's just call this block title. And then on every other page that we import or include or extend from this base, we can override it for that particular page. So let's give that a go. End block. Okay, so we can add a default. This is going to be the home page, say. So we can add a default title. So let's just give that a go. Now it says home page right here. But of course, what I want to do on the index, just remove this. What I want to do on this index is override it for this particular page. So I can add the blocked title up the top here. And then let's just call this the index page. And I can do this then for every single page, and that will then update the title, which is then relative to that page or relevant to that page. So now it says the index page. So in summary, we start with a base template. That base template has a framework, which is then going to be utilized by other templates. That saves us having to rewrite code for every single template that we generate. In this case, the HTML tags, the basic template tags are set up here in the base. And then in any other template that we generate, which is going to be rendered and viewed by the user on their browser, we're going to extend first from base. We're going to include all the code from base. And then what we're going to do is we're going to set up the base to indicate where code can be included or overridden, in this case by using blocks. So in the index here, we're simply just overriding those blocks and adding new code where code needs to be placed to indicate and to add all the tools and features of this particular page that we're working on, in this case, the index page.